Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning stuff from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1907. Fill the N cells below A1 with the digits up to the value in A1. All right, well, now this is an interesting question sent in today from YouTube. We're going to put the number 10 in cell A1, and then this 10 will distribute from cell A2 to A11. Basically, I want to distribute a cell value to the same number of cells. Now, if I understand this correctly, so we're going to put a number here, 10, and I'm just going to feed, start off with a number here of 1, but then the formula in cell A3 is going to be this. It's going to say, if the number just above us is less than the item in row 1, so A dollar sign 1, no dollar sign before the A, then I want to take 1 plus the number just above us. Otherwise, I want quote, quote. All right, and watch how this works. I'm going to copy it down, not just 10 rows, but I'm going to copy it down, 100 rows or something like that. And so now this is pretty cool. Check this out. So when I change the number in A1 from 10 to 15, I instantly get a different set of numbers. I'm not sure, exactly what we're trying to do with this, but it's an interesting way to kind of expand a series or a list based on the number that's up here. Now, the downside to this is we have all of these extra cells that, have formulas in them, like right here in my case, 465 extra rows that, for the most part, are never filled in, but we have to make it really large in case we ever, for example, would type 125 and would need some large number there. So, the formula is one way to go. Another way to go would be a macro, and here I'm going to show you how the macro works. First, I'm going to say expand numbers, click run, and then that will take those numbers and change the list below, but it's a static kind of thing. If this would change from 10 to 12, see, it doesn't automatically update. You'd have to have an event handler macro to do that. So we'll take a look at that code quickly here, just to, for each cell in selection. So I selected those three cells. For I equals 1 to cell.value, cell.offset. Offset says, hey, we're going to start from the individual cell, go down some number of rows, in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and set the value equal to the same number, 1 through 10. So tiny little macro there to handle that. And, while we're talking about filling, I just want to show off this one cool trick. I'm sure I've showed this on the podcast before. This came from Western Michigan. If I would need to fill the numbers from 1 to, let's say, 100,000, you can hold down the control key and start to drag, but that, frankly, would take forever to get to 100,000. So I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to drag down and then back up and let go and choose series from the drop-down list. And then in the fill series, I'm going to say that I want to fill a series in columns. The step value is 1, and the stop value, let's just say it's 150,000, some really big number. Click OK, and just bam, like that. Check that out. Very quickly fills down. So that whole little dance at the beginning where I put in the number 1 and grab the fill handle with the right mouse button, drag down and let go, is really just a shortcut way of coming here to the Home tab and under Fill, choosing Fill Series. Kind of a clever way to go. Again, I got that from an accounting professor up at Western Michigan, I think it was, University of Western Michigan. So kind of a cool trick there. But I think really what we're asking for here is just a way that we can enter a number and have the list automatically update based on that number. So I think my original answer there in column A is what they were looking for, but it was kind of an ambiguous question, so a couple of different alternatives there to fill some numbers. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. MrExcel.com.